In international news now, the United States and North Korea seem to be returning to a war of words. North Korea again referred to U.S. President Donald Trump as a dotard, as Mr. Trump again called its leader Kim Jong-un a rocket man. And all this comes as the year-end deadline that Pyongyang has set for Washington draws closer, and North Korea appears to be readying rocket engine test site. In South Korea, government officials and lawmakers have expressed concerns about the escalating tensions. Our senior Korea correspondent Lim Yeon-suk tells us more.
The South Korean government and political parties are worried that threats of military conflicts may once again return to the region if both sides do not dial down the tension. In the regular briefing on Friday, the Unification Ministry said the two sides appear to remain far apart.
최근에 보여준 여러 가지 이제 담화라든가 이런 것들을 보면은 북핵 협상과 관련하여 북미 간의 입장 차이가 여전히 있는 것으로 보입니다. 정부는 한반도의 항구적 평화 정착을 위해 북미 간 협상이 진전되기를 기대하며 이를 위해 할 수 있는 외교적 노력을 다해 나가도록 하겠습니다.
And in a meeting on Friday morning among lawmakers of the ruling Democratic Party to discuss a wide range of issues, including North Korea, some voiced concerns.
당초 예정된 북미 간의 대화 시간이 얼마 남지 않았습니다. 북미 사이에 오가는 말도 점점 거칠어지고 있습니다. 한반도에 또다시 전쟁 위험이 높아지지 않도록 정치권 모두의 각별한 노력이 필요한 때입니다.
Apart from the war of words, adding to the worries is that North Korea could be re-engaging in activity at the Seohae Satellite Launching Station, located on the country's west coast. Now, this is where North Korea launched satellites into space, most recently the Kwangmyongsong 4 in 2016. North Korea watchers here believe they were tests to prepare for the long-range intercontinental ballistic missiles, the ICBM, that are capable of reaching the mainland U.S. Also, this Tongchangni facility is the one that North Korean leader Kim Jong-un had promised to dismantle, and one that Mr. Trump claimed was dismantled after last June's historic summit in Singapore. There are views that the country might have renewed activity there to use it as a bargaining chip in future negotiations with the United States. Lim Yeon-suk, CNA, Seoul.